You may be wondering yourself, how does one get sick with a bloodborne pathogen? Well, bloodborne pathogens are microorganisms such as viruses that are present in human blood and can cause disease in humans. They include, but are not limited to, hepatitis B, hepatitis C, and the human immunodeficiency virus we know as HIV. Infectious disease is a disease that enters into the body through various routes that's caused by microorganisms such as bacteria, fungus, or virus. Infectious diseases can range from mild to life-threatening. For disease to be spread, it requires several conditions to be present that we call the chain of infection. There must be an adequate number of pathogens or disease-causing organisms in the environment. There must be a reservoir or a source that allows the pathogen to survive and multiply, like blood. A mode of transmission from the source to the host, and an entrance through which that pathogen may enter the host. A susceptible host is also required, which means they don't already have an immune system to that virus or bacteria. Infection control strategies serve to prevent disease transmission by interrupting one or more links in the chain of infection. The primary source of potential bloodborne pathogens is blood and specific bodily fluids like semen and vaginal secretions. Other bodily fluids may contain bloodborne pathogens, especially those visibly contaminated with blood, such as cerebrospinal fluid, which is found in the brain, synovial fluid found in the joints, pleural fluid in the lungs, and amniotic fluid, which is in the uterus and around the uterus, pericardial fluid, which is around the heart, and peritoneal fluid found in the abdomen. Urine, feces, saliva, and some other body fluids do not typically carry bloodborne pathogens. However, it can be difficult to identify a body fluid or know for sure whether or not it is contaminated with blood. In general, you should really just treat all body fluids as potentially contaminated with blood, with the potential of carrying a bloodborne pathogen disease. So, how does a bloodborne pathogen or infectious disease get into your body? Well, there's four basic modes of transmission. The first one is direct contact. Direct contact occurs when microorganisms are transferred from one infected person directly to another person. Examples would include a body artist who has an open uncovered wound and blood from a client contacts that wound. There's also parenteral exposure. Now this means that the infected blood is introduced directly into your body through piercing the skin. Examples include a needle stick injury or a cut with a sharp piece of material that's been contaminated. Indirect contact means that it came from an object or a tool, then got onto the person's open skin. So what is really important here is to make sure that we are decontaminating any of those objects that might actually have blood or blood product on them. Airborne transmission is another way to get it. This is when droplets or small particles containing the infectious agent remain effective for some time, float around, and then are inhaled into the body. An example of this might be like tuberculosis. Most bloodborne pathogens do not fall into that category. So, what's the most common way bloodborne pathogens are spread? Needle stick and sexual contact are our most potential risks. The highest potential risk while working with clients exists when a contaminated sharp object cuts or punctures the skin. An example would include a needle stick, a cut from a broken piece of glass, cut from a razor used on a client, etc. A medium potential risk exists when infected body fluid gets into an open cut or mucous membrane, such as into the eyes, the mouth, the ears, or the nose. The lowest potential risk is when a contaminated object touches inflamed skin, acne, or skin abrasion. In addition to knowing how bloodborne pathogens are spread, it is just as important to know how bloodborne pathogens are not spread. Intact skin is our first line of defense against disease. Bloodborne pathogens cannot soak through normal intact skin. The Centers for Disease Control, otherwise known as the CDC, states that there is no known risk from exposure to intact skin. Like some infectious diseases, bloodborne pathogens are not spread by casual contact, such as handshakes, hugging, doorknobs, or use of the same equipment, like toilets or water fountains.